Today I'm going to show you guys how to make this cool logo design using the Shape Builder tool in Adobe Illustrator. So what is up people, welcome back to Satori Graphics, home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today we're going to be looking at using the Shape tool in Adobe Illustrator to design a really cool and symmetrical logo design. I'm also going to show you guys some nifty gradient tricks that you can use on this logo design. I quickly want to remind you all that if you want to follow the link in the description below or in the top right corner, you can access my Teespring store with a 20% discount on any purchase until Tuesday. So if you want to help out Satori Graphics, grab yourself a shirt or a print to show your appreciation to this channel. To make your life a little bit easier when designing this logo today with the Shape Builder tool, it's going to be a good idea to activate specific smart guides in your Illustrator preferences window. So if you see my settings here, I advise that you use similar settings for your logo design. You can press Shift and X on your keyboard to switch between a stroke and a fill. Press M on your keyboard to access the rectangle tool and then go ahead and make a rectangle in a similar manner to mine here. We then will want to make a perfect circle, so access the ellipse tool with L on your keyboard. You hold down Shift and click and drag to make a perfect circle, and make the diameter of the circle around double the size of the rectangle. We can, however, make sure it's perfectly double the size by opening up the transform window. Using the transform window, we can see the height of the rectangle if we select it. So as you can see here, mine is 93. If we then go ahead and select the circle, we can see the circle's diameter. We want it to be double, so mine's going to be 186, which is double 93. We can type in those dimensions and the circle will now be perfectly double the size of the rectangle. In this tutorial, using the Shape Builder tool to make a logo, it's essential everything is perfect. We then want to align the circle so it aligns on the corner of the rectangle like so. The fact we turned on the smart guides earlier would now allow Illustrator to inform you when the circle is perfectly aligned with the intersect quote. So when you have the first circle set up for our Shape Builder logo design in Illustrator, hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate the shape. Move the circle to the other side of the rectangle and place it perfectly on the edge like we did before, but this time position it below rather than above. Lastly, make another circle but resize it down to a little under half of the original size, and then position it like I've done here. We're nearly ready to start using the Shape Builder tool now. So once you have everything aligned and positioned, you're going to be able to find the Shape Builder tool here in the toolbar. Or you can also press Shift and M on your keyboard. You need to select everything that makes up the shape selection and then access the Shape Builder tool. By default, it's going to be a plus icon above the cursor, and this will allow you to click and drag over areas that you want to unite together to make up the logo design shape. However, here I need to adjust a smaller circle so that it touches the edge of the other circle properly. So when you're ready, click and drag to draw over the selections like I've done here. Now hold down the Alt Option key, and then when you click and drag over the areas that you don't want, they're going to be deleted. This will leave our first shape for our logo design. You might also want to select and delete areas finishing and tidying up your design. So flick the shape from a stroke over to a fill. We now have our first shape ready. Duplicate it with the Alt Option key and then rotate it by 180 degrees. You can then position it to make up the final shape of our logo design in today's tutorial. I'm going to show you a few tricks on adding quality gradients to the logo design that's coming up next. So for the first top shape, we're going to add a warm gradient. So highlight it and then select the gradient fill. All you need to do is click each side of the slider and then add a color that you wish. You can experiment with this for your logo design, but make sure the direction travels from left to right like so. On the bottom shape, we're going to use a cooler gradient that goes from purple to a kind of light blue. And like I said, I will show you a neat trick in a moment that's really going to give your logo design more depth. Make sure that you direct the darker part of the gradient coming from the center of the logo design. We can add multiple layers of gradients to give a smoother and more in-depth appearance. So on the bottom shape here, click it and then press Command or Control C to copy it, and then press Command or Control F, which is going to paste and duplicate it exactly with the top. On the duplicate, I want to change the direction of the gradient slightly. But more importantly, I want to change the light side to have a 0% opacity, and on the darker side, I'm going to make it a bit more darker than the original. So as you can see, this is what you're left with at the end. To save us time today, I've gone ahead and done the same thing with the top shape. However, we can add one more final gradient layer to both shapes. So copy the new gradient and then paste it in place like we did before. This time we can make the lighter side more brighter and the dark side to have a 0% opacity. So take your time playing around with the color so that it both acts like a highlight and blends in properly into your logo design. Then finally, do the same on the lower shape, making the lighter side of the gradient brighter and the darker side having no opacity. And there, as you can see, the logo looks more dramatic and visually appealing than with the single gradient used. Let me know what you guys think of today's logo design tutorial. So there is today's tutorial on how to use the Shape Builder tool to design this logo in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video in the comment section below. I always love hearing your feedback and your comments on my content. Also, remember to get 20% off any purchase on my Teespring store. So if you do want to help out my channel, go over to Teespring using the link in the description below and get 20% off any purchase. Like and share my content if you do find it useful. And of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.